Recently at work, we had our internal hackathon. This is a chance for employees to work on an idea they think might be interesting in some way. Many people work on tasks they've wanted to do for a while at work, and others do things that have nothing to do with the company's product. The goal is to learn something new and have some fun doing it. This was my 7th hackathon I've participated in at the company in my 5.5 years there. The way this works is that everyone who has an idea shares it at the presentations at the start of day one. Sometimes your idea resonates with someone else, and they want to help. Then you have until the presentations at 4 p.m. the next day to work on it. The company brought in all meals so that we had no hurdles to finishing our projects. So I had an idea in the days leading up to the event. I was thinking of working on a kubectl plugin using krew, but someone else mentioned a need for an integration between two websites that we use. The integration, probably just a Chrome extension or a Tamper Monkey script, sounded super easy. So I thought I could whip that out in the morning and then start and maybe even finish my idea as well. Yeah, wishful thinking. Building the integration took much longer than I expected, mainly because I had no recent experience with building a Chrome extension. So in this video, I thought I'd show you what's involved with building a Chrome extension. Now, I can't go into detail about the one I built, since it uses an internal tool which I may or may not be allowed to show you. Plus, I like to keep my work life separate from this channel. So here's the plan. I'm going to build a Chrome extension that modifies the name of the author of a package on GitHub based on a cool name generator on a different site. It won't show you everything you need to know about Chrome extensions, but enough to get you going. Note that I like to use TypeScript instead of JavaScript, so I'll be using that. Why? Well, it's just a superset of JavaScript that helps you write better JavaScript. All plus side and really no downside. My name is Matt Williams, and I'm an evangelist at a software company. I love to create videos about the tools I use to get my job done. If videos like this are interesting to you, consider subscribing, and be sure to hit that notification button as well. I'm somewhat random with my output schedule, so subscribing is the best way to find out there's a new video. To get started, I'm using Yeoman, which is a great scaffolding tool. You can find out more at yeoman.io and install it with npm install -g yo. And the Yeoman generator I use is the Chrome extension kickstart TypeScript, which you can find here. Run npm install -g generator Chrome extension kickstart TypeScript to install that. Now, create a directory to work from and run yo and choose that generator. Set the name and description, then decide what kind of UI action you want. I'm using browser. If you want to override a page, then select it here, but I'm choosing no. Now I want to use some content scripts, so I'll select that. And now permissions. I really need to read up on this because I don't really know what to select here. So I'll just grab it all. And I don't care about the promo images. Let everything install, then open the folder in a code editor like VS Code. There's a lot in here, but really the important stuff is in the app directory. In scripts, we have background, content script, and pop-up. I'll uncomment the Chrome reload lines in each file. Open the terminal in VS Code and run gulp --watch. Now, if gulp isn't installed, go to gulpjs.com and run the command there to install it globally, then try that command again. Now go to Chrome, Extensions, and enable Dev Mode. That will let us load an unpacked extension. Click Load Unpacked and navigate to the folder with your new extension. And go to dist/chrome and click Select. So I mentioned that I wanted to update the GitHub owner's name. So find a GitHub repository page. In the last video, I worked with brew, so homebrew/brew is a good one to go to. Right-click on Homebrew at the top and choose Inspect. Here we can see the HTML for that part of the page. I can see that it's an A tag with attribute of rel equals author, so in my content script, I'll use the document query selector method to look for that element on the page. Let's make sure we have this element I'm thinking of by logging it to the console. Cool. So maybe update the inner HTML to be a simple name. Awesome. That works. Recently, I heard an episode of Switched on Pop podcast, and they mentioned that Donald Glover came up with the name Childish Gambino by feeding his name into the Wu-Tang Clan name generator. So I looked around for an API that will allow me to convert any name. Using an API would just make this a lot easier. So looking at the description at wuNameAsAService.HerokuApp.com, I see that the URL to use is wuNameAAS.HerokuApp.com/wuAMI/Donald Glover. Remember in the brew video, I installed Postman. Well, I can feed this into Postman and then try it out. And I see that I get the response, but it's in the form of a web page. The docs on the page say that if I update the accept header, I can customize the output. Set accept to text/plain, and I get just the result. Okay, let's move this request over to the code. One of the especially cool features of Postman is that it can generate the code for you. I often forget the parameters to use, so this helps get me to the right solution quicker. I'll choose JavaScript, fetch, and copy the output and paste it into the code editor. Right away, I see there's an error, but just letting TypeScript know the type lets me know I'm doing things right. When I save and refresh, I see things are working, so I can try moving this line that replaces the text into the then of my promise, replacing the hard-coded name with the Wu name. But that's Donald Glover's name, not homebrew. So I can pass author name into the API call. Refresh the browser and I see that Zexy Bandit is homebrew's name. But is that what it should be? Passing homebrew into Postman and I get the same result. So I guess that's right. Of course, you might have noticed that Donald Glover's Wu-Tang name is showing up as Pesty Demon and not Childish Gambino. Well, most other names show up correctly, but for some reason, Donald Glover is different. Since it's a different site, I assumed they would all be different. But let's say we want to use the same site Donald Glover used. That site is mess.b/iNickGenWuName.php. But there isn't an API for that one. Instead, you type a name in the text box and click the button to get the results. But we can still make this work. Go to the page, right-click on the button, and click Inspect. You can see the form action is the iNickGenWuName.php file with a text box called RealName and a Submit button with the value of Enter the Wu-Tang. Switch to the Network tab and click the Record button and enter a name and press the button. It's made the request, and we need to figure out what it did. Now, normally, I would look under XHR for a JavaScript file that did an AJAX call. But this site is ancient. The date at the bottom is 2002, and I think the early AJAX work was done at Microsoft in the time that I worked there back around early 2000. So this is just a simple PHP page. Let's go to the doc tab, and we see that PHP page and that it's a post. Scroll down to the bottom, and we see our form entries. Plug that into Postman, and we get an HTML page with Childish Gambino in there somewhere. Again, grab the code and paste it into our code editor. Try it out, and we hit a snag. We're getting some errors. First, there's something about cookies, but more important, we're getting CORB errors. And this is a problem that we can't really get around if we keep everything in the content script. But thankfully, we can do this in the background script. But how do we get the output of background to show it in the content script? Well, it all comes down to message passing. In your content script, call chrome.runtime.sendMessage, passing in the data you want to send, and a callback you want to run with a response. And in the background script, call chrome.runtime.onMessage.addListener with a callback to do the work. So let's just cut the mess.b code and deal with the content script. I'll send the message with the author name, and assume that I'll get a response of the new Wu-Tang name. I'll update the page with that name. Okay, now for the background. Let's add our listener and paste in the code that we just cut. Above that, log out the request object. In the promises then block, we're doing a console log of the result. Refresh the browser to see what we've done so far, but there doesn't seem to be anything there. and we can't even see the console log from the background script. So go to the extensions page and click the link to inspect the background page. Notice that we're getting the full HTML of the page, and above that, we can see the request object. So we can see we're passing the object with author name and getting back the full HTML. Let's look at the real resulting page and inspect the name. Right-click on the element and choose Copy Selector. Now we can parse the resulting text and enter this query selector. We need to use inner HTML to get to the actual name, but we can send that to the content script using send response. And look at the page. That's awesome. It works. So now you've seen a couple of ways to get what we want, and you will always see the Wu-Tang names for all of your favorite open source tool developers. To prove that it's different on other pages, let's take a look at some of the GitHub pages for my colleagues. Here is G. Waldo, aka Foolish Artist, Burning Ion, aka Mad Conqueror, and Jason Yi, or J. Yi, aka Master Destroyer, which is interesting because he just moved to Gremlin that does chaos engineering. My name is Matt Williams, and you've just watched another video on the TechnoEvangelist channel. If you liked the video, please click the thumbs up button. And if you aren't already subscribed, then please do. You will then be sure to find the next video when it comes out. Thanks so much for watching. Goodbye.